Okay, today let's try out our South Indian authentic Karnataka dish, Bisibele Bhat.
Yay!
Hello all, welcome to another episode of Cooking by IIG. My name is Shashi Nadek. Let's see what all the ingredients we need. So we are not going to use any powder here today. We are going to make the fresh powder for the Bisibele Bhat. So let's see what all the ingredients we need, okay? So I have taken about 1 cup of chana dal, 1 cup of cumin seed or the jeera, 1 cup of coriander seeds, 1/2 cup of the urad dal, 1 inch of cinnamon seeds. So let's see what we need for the Bisibele Bhat from the vegetable side. I have taken about 2 onions which are cube size cut. Two to three big potatoes, again cut into this size. 2 big carrots, about a quarter kilo of the beans, the peas. I have soaked this overnight, and a small amount of the groundnut. And then I used and I've taken 2 tablespoons of tamarind. Juice, 2 tablespoons or whatever the amount you need for the taste for salt, and using this rice cooker cup for the tur dal, it's about 1 cup. I soaked it for about 1 to 2 hours, and 1.5 cup of the rice. Again, this is also soaked for 1 to 2 hours now. Now let's see what we need for the garnishing or the tadka. About 1 or 2 bell peppers. I have taken the green, you can take any color. Dry coconut, thin sliced, cashews, any amount, whatever you need for how much ever you need for the kids or even for your taste. Some curry leaves, and about 2 spoon of the ghee, and a pinch of the ing. I will use it. One thing to remember while you choosing the vegetable is, apart from these vegetables which I've shown here, you can put only one more vegetable into Bisibele Bhat. You should not put anything else. That vegetable is called as Navil Kos in Karnataka. In North India, it is called as Nol Khol. Or in Maharashtra, it is called as Naval Khol. That is the only extra vegetable you can mix. Don't try to put any other vegetables. That will ruin the taste of the Bisibele Bhat. Okay, let's start the process of making the Bisibele Bhat powder now. I'm going to do a dry roast of all the stuff, the urad dal and all the dal. If you are going to keep this for longer time, you need to dry roast it, and you have to roast them separately. If you are going to use them immediately, you can use a little amount of ghee or the oil, however it suits. I'm going to do a dry roast. But I will mix all of them because I am not making too much of the powder. So we'll put the coriander leaves at the last. All other ones we can. So I'm putting all the ones except the coriander seeds. Then we'll put that at the last. I am roasting this for about 3 to 4 minutes in a medium flame. As soon as we put the coriander seeds for a minute and a half, it will start the aromatic smell. That's when you can stop your roasting. I will roast for another 30 seconds and I am going to switch it off. It's been about 3.5 minutes now. So once it is roasted, now I put that aside for the cooling down. So let's look at making the Bisibele Bhat here. So I put the flame on the medium, and then I started with the dal. In India, we usually get a very hard dal. So basically, my mom and you know all my ancestors, they used to make is they used to boil the dal once already. So now the masala mixture is cooled down, so I transferred everything into the mixy jar. So let's make a fine powder of it. So now dal is boiling for about 7 to 8 minutes. I got a head start with for the dal, and I'm going to mix the rice and the vegetables. So trust me, adding the vegetables to the boiling water will add more taste than adding everything at one shot and just closing the pressure cooker. So this is something I learned from mom. So let's add that, all the vegetables. And I've taken the freshly made powder and I'm going to add that. Remaining water. You can see how much you need usually with the rice, and I'm going to put the pressure cooker cover and close it till it makes one pressure sir. Now it's ready to give out the first whistle. So as soon as we get the whistle sound, we can switch off the cooker and keep it for cooling. Okay, now let's open the cooker and see how it's been done. Wow, I can smell the aromatic taste of the bisibale bath. Let's put the tadka now, and then we can serve this. Okay, now I have put about two spoons of ghee and heated it up. Now let's go on with the tadka part. And now let's put the bell pepper. If you put the bell pepper in the cooker, it will get mushy, that's why we should not do that. Okay, now the tadka is done. Let's pour this into the bisibale bath and switch on the cooker. mix it well. Okay, now the bisibale bath is ready. I have served this in a half plate and put some. So I have put a small spoon of the ghee and the kara bundi to serve it.
Daddy, is bisibale bath ready for tasting?
Yeah, let's taste it and see how the taste. Okay.
Good.